Welcome back to my next little project, the Tailgate folding down table. I've been enjoying many fishing trips up to the sunny coast, on driving on Noosa North Shore or up to Double Island Point, and I've decided that I don't have enough room to prepare my yummy meals and brekkies. And after looking online, discovered the fold down tailgate table, which a lot of 4B owners have been using, and Prado especially has a very flat tailgate panel, which is ideal for a fold down table. So I've decided to join the bandwagon, so to speak, and build my own. Bought myself a little router, another one of the Ryobi cordless attachments. So I had a bit of a practice. Trin also gave me a bit of a hand, rounding the corners off the router, and then a little 6mm bit. I'm going to put a nice edge, rounded edge on the fold down table. Once all that's done, then I'll coat it with some epoxy resin. Something shimmering and white. Well, I finished the routing and edging of the table. It's a pretty good finish, I'm very pleased. My first time using a router, so very exciting for a newbie like me. But giving it a bit of a sand, so it's nice and smooth. So I'll take it inside and I'll dust it off first, take it inside, and I'll be ready to give it the first coat of epoxy resin. Welcome back. We're doing the first coat of epoxy resin. Getting some great help from my beautiful Trin. So this is the boat coat, two-part resin and epoxy, with the additive TPRVA, I think it's called, which is a thinner as well as a rot inhibitor, which they recommend as a first coat, so it soaks in and helps preserve the wood. After which you then apply two more coats of the boat coat, two-part epoxy resin proper. So we're just doing the first side of the table, and then we'll flip her over and do the other side.
So we're now just blowtorching the wood, well, the stuff on the wood, to get rid of all the bubbles.
Yeah, epoxy resin.
I reckon
it's not the heat, but the carbon dioxide that pops on the bubbles.
Yeah.
Thanks, Trin. First coat, all done. Good job. There's a lady who's sure all that glitters is gold, and she's buying the stairway. When she gets there, she knows if the stores are all closed. With the word she can get what she can. Well, I've just given it a very good sand on both sides. That was after giving it a first undercoat with the bow coat and the thinner TPRDA, which is the anti-rot protectant. It was pretty bumpy and bubbly, and so I really needed to give it a good sand to cut it right back to smooth again. But at least the sort of little top surface of the wood is nice and primed. I'm just going to sand the edges and then I'll be ready to give it its first real coat of boat coat. Welcome back. It's been about a week, maybe 3 or 4 days since I last coated this table with some epoxy resin. I've just put the third and final coat on the top side. So I've put a primer coat on with this boat coat epoxy resin 2-pack. The first coat I put some TPRDA, which is this rot protection which I keep going on about. First coat, I sanded that back. I then put a second coat of just the boat coat on and let it cure for a couple of days, and then I put a third coat. I put a third coat on Thursday, then I went fishing and I've just put the final coat on the top side. I've decided this is the top side because I put an extra large or an extra thick coat, so hopefully as it'll get more use, hopefully it'll be thicker and offer better protection. Anyway, it looks like it's pretty good. I've decided to elevate my work's surface, so instead of painting it on the floor, I've made a makeshift workbench. Hopefully that will reduce the amount of dust that settles on the top. I've shut all the doors and windows and kept it pretty still in here, so the dust has not stirred up too much, I hope. And as you can hopefully see, it's pretty shiny. I got the old blowtorch out and as in the YouTube videos, watching the experts do the epoxy resining. The blowtorch is very effective at removing any bubbles that come through. So as far as I can tell, it looks pretty smooth. There were a few bubbles, but you just wave that blowtorch over the top and they disappear. You don't leave it too long, otherwise you start burning the epoxy resin. So. Welcome back. I've finally received my shiny new hinges, friction hinges from Gemlux in the States, and I've measured them all up, screwed them into the top of the tabletop, and about to rivet them into the back panel. So Nat's here to give me a hand. Hey Nat.
Hey.
Okay. I'm doing the top one. Push the plate. Keep your fingers away from the rivet because it's going to fall. Alright, now a shot from the back. I'm looking forward to seeing this because I've never seen a rivet.
It looks cool, it's funny.
Push the plate this end. Yeah. Watch your fingers.
Yep.
Good?
Yep.
Alright, and the other one.
Yep.
Push the plate towards me hard.
Got it.
Ready?
Yep.
These are stainless steel countersunk rivets. They fit very nicely into the hinges, which are countersunk. And I had a bit of scrap stainless steel rectangular hollow square tubing. So we'll just cut a few plates out of it for backing plates to rivet into. And the final hinge.
Yeah.
heaven.